Before we enter into a relationship with another person, especially an intimate relationship, most people will take a moment to ask themselves two sets of questions. The first set usually has to do with, is this person going to be good to me? Are they likely to make me happy and support me, both in the short and in the longer term? Or does the relationship make sense for another reason? Is this person someone that a trusted friend or family member has recommended that I get to know? The second set of questions usually has to do with, how well do I know this person? How much do I know about their history? Where do they come from? And what kinds of things have they done in the past? We can also think about the act of eating as something like an intimate relationship. We're actually putting a great deal of trust in that bite of food when we allow it to enter our bodies. Take a moment to think about something you ate recently. Did you believe that food was going to be good for you, not just in the moment by bringing you short-term pleasure, but in the longer term too, by helping you feel strong and healthy and good about yourself? And secondly, think about how much you knew about where that food came from. Did you buy it at a local farmer's market or maybe even grow it yourself? Did you or somebody you trust cook it for you using mostly fresh ingredients? Or did you know very little about where that food came from and what it was made of? If the food came in a package, can you picture each of the ingredients listed on the label? Are they familiar ingredients that you can pronounce? Take a moment now to pause this video and think about something you ate recently. Then ask yourself those questions. Was that food good for me? And how well did I know that food? Now, here's your food mindfulness challenge. Next time you're about to eat something, pause and take a few moments to ask yourself, is this food likely to make me feel good now and in the future? And how well do I know this food? See if those questions start to change the decisions you make about the kinds of foods you eat. See you next time for another exercise in Food for Thought.